Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. So in this video I wanted to share a case of thyroiditis. So what was the case about and what were the symptoms and what drug did I select? Keep watching this video, know about that. So it was goiter of a female around like 30 to 35 of age, and she has been suffering with some kind of discomfort while swallowing and some kind of sensation of something stuck in the throat since 2 years. And she has been on hypothyroid medicine, that is like Thyronorm 25 MCG, since 5 months. And some other peculiar symptoms that has been observed by me is like whatever it may be, she used to suffer with a kind of discomfort or a kind of restlessness around like 7 p.m. every day. She complained, or say she specifically pointed out, it's like evenings I'm really really worse shape of my health. So she said something like that, and there was a slight swelling on the throat as well. So it was clearly evident that it was of a thyroid. So she USG of scan revealed that there is a bilateral nodular formation, and there is like a thyroiditis, inflammation of thyroid gland. And so her TSH was around like 8 to 9. So she's on currently medication. So coming to the symptoms, as I said, evening kind of discomfort aggravation was there, and she's kind of like a bit chilly. Warm weather, she desired warm weather coming to the physical generals, and nothing else was much peculiar. So I gave her graphitis actually. Graphitis, because if you go through the drug picture of graphitis, it's clearly evident that the women, it's like generally adaptable to the women, and who are like chilly and who suffer with constipation generally and menstrual irregularities. I forgot to say that even these women had menstrual irregularities. The periods generally are like 45 days to 60 days once, so like once in 1.5 to 2 months. It's been since like 5 months, so like at the time where she was like diagnosed with suffering with hypothyroidism. So these are the complaints. And so coming back to graphitis, I just gave graphitis. Is generally whenever I don't find so much peculiar things, or whenever I can't come to a conclusion in the first go itself, I generally tend to start my hypothyroid cases generally with graphitis. It really gave me a good result because of this affinity, and also because of this close similarity between the symptoms of graphitis drug picture and with hypothyroidism. It has really really given me good results. So I went with graphitis, but I somehow suspected her to be lycopodium. Why I would say, because the USG scan revealed bilateral thyroid growth, thyroid enlargement, but there was a nodular growth specifically only on the right lobe of thyroid. That was first suspicion. And second thing was evening aggravation of complaints. Like if generally you go to lycopodium, that is like 4 to 8 p.m. aggravation of symptoms was there. And she was constantly saying that 7 p.m. thing. So that's one more thing I just got suspicion about. And so these were the two suspicions. But I somehow just, whenever I look at a case in my OP, I just tend to write it in bracket. If I get a suspicion, it to be another remedy, so that I can refer it and I can give it as a follow-up stuff. So I just pointed out in bracket in as lycopodium, and again I repertorize the case in classic computer repertory. So after doing, you know, again considering all these symptoms of like hypothyroidism and right-sided swelling and difficulty in swallowing, and of course evening aggravation of complaints and a kind of desires for warm weather, so all these symptoms surprisingly pointed towards lycopodium. That was something really it was like very shocking for me. A remedy which I thought like remotely possible because of 2 or 3 characteristics really pointed out to be covering even the remaining symptoms as well. So obviously she'll be getting lycopodium in the coming follow-ups. And surprisingly, graphitis, lycopodium complements graphitis action. It is given in boric as well. So all this stuff really boosted my confidence, and I was really happy I could crack a case very much good according to the repertory. So that's what I wanted to share in this video, guys. So many of you people are asking like follow-ups. As you all know, I work with a government firm, so it's really hard to keep up the track of the follow-ups, but I'm really making sure that I will be following up them as much as possible, but don't get focused much upon the result. I just wanted you guys to get that habit of looking in between the symptoms, so that you can understand and how get to a conclusion of two or three group of remedies, or say at the end at least one remedy, how to get to that conclusion and how to get a habit of that. I just wanted you guys to learn through these clinical cases videos. So again, a disclaimer, this case which I discussed, or say the remedy which I prescribed for this clinical condition, if you suffer with similar condition, I would like to advise you to consult a doctor by yourself. Don't take this medication which I just mentioned. It's only for educational purposes. So that's what I wanted to share in this video, guys. Hope this video was helpful. If so, don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Till then, bye bye and have a great day. Bye.